Hey Virgo, thanks for checking out your weekly reading for October 11th through the 17th. This is going to be for Virgo, Sun, Moon, and Rising. Now I am setting the intention for the 11th through the 17th, but my darlings, these energies are going to be around for a while, okay? So don't be surprised if you happen to stumble upon this video after the 11th through the 17th, but yet still you're like, holy moly, that's happening right now. These are going to be energies that are going to be around for a while. Keep in mind, these are general readings for the general collective. Therefore, not every message will resonate. Take the ones that do, leave the ones that don't. Alrighty, my darlings, let's see what's coming up here. And what messages are coming in here for Virgo, Sun, Moon, and Rising. One more shuffle. All right. I'm seeing the number one. And it feels like it's a very solid, very like firmly placed, unmovable number one. So maybe you're number one in something right now, Virgo. But I do also feel there's a sense here of like some kind of new beginning. And you're like, I'm not messing this up. I'm not messing this up. I have my little foundation put into place. Like, this is it. I'm not going to keep starting over. So I feel like there's this sense or this feeling of like, you might feel like you're coming into, like, this is what my life is going to be like until, you know, for the rest of the time I'm on this planet. Like a very, very firm, something like very firmly established. The first card that's coming up here for you, Virgo, is the Chariot. Okay. This can be Cancer energy. So this could be Cancer, Sun, Moon, or Rising. If you have a Cancer placement, there could be big changes happening for you in that area of your life. Overall, this is a Major Arcana card. So the Major Arcana cards are always going to come up anytime that we're at a significant new chapter in our life. We're coming into a significant crossroads. So you can expect there to be big changes when we're at these kinds of transitions. This is also a card about movement. Some of you may be preparing to physically travel. You may be preparing to travel, and some of you may be changing your plans where you had a plan of how you were going to go or get there, and you may be deciding now that you're going to go by car or by bus. You may be deciding to turn it into a road trip, or maybe you were planning on taking an extensive trip someplace and you're deciding to do something a little bit more locally, something closer to home, or something that you're able to actually drive to. Looking at it from a spiritual standpoint, not taking it so literally, this is a card that always makes me think of the quote by Ralph Waldo Emerson. And Ralph Waldo Emerson said, "Once we make a decision, the universe conspires to make it happen." So for me, in my readings, this is a card very much about free will and decisions and choices. And I see this card come up for a lot of people when you might feel like, okay, universe, like, show me what to do. You know, angels, guides, you know, open the door you want me to go down. You know, help me out and open the door you want me to go down. And they're like, we have to honor your free will. We can open the door, but you have to tell us which door. We're not allowed to choose the door for you in this situation. So a lot of the times, I see the Chariot card come up when you're at a lesson in your life about free will, exercising your free will, making your choices, making your decisions. So I feel that there's some shifts or some changes happening here, as well as some travel for many of you Virgos. The next card that's coming up here is the Emperor. Now we have Major Arcana cards coming in back to back. When the Major Arcana cards come in back to back, that tells me you're going through a massive energetic shift, okay? An energetic upgrade even, where you're coming out of past life agreements and contracts that no longer serve you. You're breaking out of old karma that no longer serves you. And you're coming into this energy of... you're coming into this energy here of awakening, growth, okay, new agreements. So anytime the Major Arcana cards come in back to back, it's big changes in a short period of time. If we want to look at the cards in a very literal sense, Some of you can be dealing with maybe making travel to see a father or father figure, or making travel in preparation for stepping into fatherhood or patriarch energy. Some of you may be preparing to step into patriarch energy or to visit and sit with a patriarch, and like preparing for that torch to be passed. Maybe some of you are having to expedite plans for travel because you may receive word, like if you have parents who are older, there may be some. I'm so sorry, guys. I'm so sorry. There's repairs being made here. And as always, nobody gives me a damn heads up at all. So please forgive me. There's going to be loud noises. So when you have the Emperor card coming up, this can indicate that for some of you, you have a father figure. Maybe you have like an ailing father, and you might receive word that he's not doing well. There might be things happening here where you're like expediting your plans. Maybe you were going to like go home for Christmas, and now you're like, I don't know if I want to wait that long, right? So some of you might be expediting plans and making this travel sooner. There can be also, if you do have like a grandfather or father who has passed over, the Emperor can mean that you have messages coming in from the other side. You may be receiving visitations. They may be knocking right now. You may be receiving messages from a paternal side of your family in terms of a crossroads that you're coming up upon. You might be receiving messages and guidance. Some of you might be making plans or decisions because you do feel like you're stepping into like having to be leader. And so you might have your ancestors who were the leaders of the family previously coming in and guiding you in your leadership, in the choices and the decisions that you're making. Okay, that could be also something happening here where there's some intervention, there's some help coming to you from the spiritual realm through dreams, through visitations, from the father's side of the family when we see the Emperor. Emperor is also the divine masculine, okay? This is all of the kings rolled up into one, okay? So there's the intellectual, no-nonsense, you know, negotiator, good communicator, king of swords. There's the business-oriented, money-oriented, successful king of pentacles. There's the creative, very fatherly, intuitive, psychic king of cups. And there's the life of the party, entrepreneur, you know, quick thinking, you know, sexy energy, passionate energy, king of wands, right? There's all these four types of kings. And so the Emperor is going to be embodying each and every single one of those elements. Okay. So if you are masculine energy, if you are male, you may be finding that you're beginning to make peace with these different parts of yourself. Maybe for a long time you felt like, you know what? I shouldn't be the king of pentacles. I should be more of a king of cups. You know what? I'm tired of being king of cups. I want to live my life. I want to be happy. I want to have fun. I want to be the king of wands. You're finding a way to reconcile all these different aspects of you, right? They don't have to go into compartments. They don't have to go into boxes. You're a little bit of everything. And so you're embracing and accepting all aspects of yourself, and you're coming into a sense of completeness. And if you are searching for masculine energy in your life, you are manifesting this kind of masculine energy coming into your life. Your next card coming up here is the Six of Cups. So there could be definitely a reconciliation. Some of you may be trying to make peace with a paternal figure, or to make sense or understanding something happening with the father's side of the family. Okay, Six of Cups can also be feeling very sentimental. You might be making a trip or preparing for a trip that maybe is bringing up a lot of things about the past, right? Here in the United States, we are coming up on the holidays, and a lot of people get very sentimental around the holidays. They really think about families and relationships. And so whether you are preparing to travel to see family, or to go to a childhood home, or you're just kind of in this more sentimental energy, Six of Cups can be that you're thinking a lot about your past, a lot about your childhood. And this card can sometimes come up because we're in a cycle of a lot of self-blame, where you're like, well, things were so good back then, but I made bad choices, or things were so good back then and I messed it up, or, you know, woulda, shoulda, coulda. Well, the Six of Cups wants you to know that you made the best choices that you could make with the options that were available to you at the time. And sometimes as humans, we have a tendency to remember the past much better than it actually was. And so this is reminding us that sometimes we remember things better than they were. And things happen for a reason. You didn't just one day wake up and make decisions and choices for no reason. Okay, so to be in peace about your past, to be in peace about decisions that you've made, and to try to be in the present moment. Okay, the Six of Cups, we might be too much in the past energy. There could be a reconciliation that some of you are working towards as well, wanting to make peace. I'm hearing burying the hatchet. Some of you may be traveling to try to bury the hatchet, so to speak, or preparing some kind of trip or closure. I also feel that in this time, there's some kind of grieving or mourning that you're going to be doing. So maybe some of you are visiting grave sites of family members, and you're processing and grieving losses, or processing really missing somebody. Some of you might be in the process of burying this hatchet. You may be grieving this relationship. You may be grieving a way that you feel like maybe they let you down, or they weren't there for you. Or, you know, you've had to do so much on your own and they just don't see it. They're just not going to wake up, and they're not going to realize, you know, the consequences that their actions and decisions had for you on your life. But I do feel there's a release happening here. Now, the next card coming up for you, Virgo, is the Page of Wands. And the Page of Wands can be, it doesn't have to be a fire sign person. It can be a fire sign person or a younger fire sign person. So the fire signs are going to be Aries, Sagittarius, or Leo. It can be you if you have a fire sign placement. You may be tapping into or connecting with your fire sign energy, or you may be encountering or dealing with someone who has Page of Wands energy, regardless of their zodiac sign. So, Page of Wands, if it's you stepping into Page of Wands energy, you may be coming into your whole like second adolescence. Like, you're getting your fire back, you're getting your groove back, you're getting your confidence back, you're wanting to get out there and enjoy life again. There can be like a zeal and a passion for life that maybe you had lost, and you're getting that fire back, and you're wanting to get involved in things that you're interested in and things that excite you, and like finding your group, finding your tribe. So you may be kind of putting yourself out there again, and like wanting to enjoy life, wanting to experience life, kind of like feeling like a teenager again, okay? I'm not going to focus too much on love and romance in this reading. If you want more of like a deeper love romance reading, you can click on the love reading link in the description where I have the love readings for October. But there could be something here where somebody is just kind of bringing out that fire energy out of you. This could be somebody who's inspiring you, who's a bit of a muse, okay? So this is somebody that might be inspiring you, bringing you inspiration into your life, getting you excited about the future. The thing about the Page of Wands, though, however, is you do want to be cautious to where you don't get too carried away. That doesn't mean that this is a bad person, or that they have ill intention towards you. It's just that you want to be cautious that you don't lose yourself in this to where you start to abandon your logic and reason. Because in the beginning, I saw that number one and it was planted very firmly. And so maybe this Page of Wands is like really inspiring, and you're like, wait a minute, I've been making a lot of really good progress. Or you're catching that Page of Wands energy yourself, and you're like, wait a minute, I've been making a lot of new progress. You can enjoy that Page of Wands energy. Just don't abandon your logic or reason. Don't, you know, like, you know, talk things out. Make logical decisions. You can take these two energies and you can combine them. You can have both of them. They can coexist. It's just a matter of not letting yourself get lost in the energy, not, you know, letting you let yourself run away with it. Okay? Maybe some of you have been thinking about running away with somebody. And so maybe this is saying, like, look, you can have the excitement, but you don't have to abandon responsibility. You don't have to abandon obligation. These two parts of yourself can coexist, right? Like they can be together. There can be the fun and exciting adventurous you, and there could be the leader, the responsible you. You don't have to make sacrifices. You're gonna have to set boundaries. Right? But when we set boundaries, it can help us so that we don't have to make sacrifices, right? You may be finding that you're dividing your time up for your different interests or your different focuses or your different relationships, okay? So setting boundaries here and having a sense of adventure, having a sense of joy, having a sense of fire and passion in your life. It doesn't have to be boring responsibility versus excitement. You don't have to give up one for the other. You can bring these two together when you have the right boundaries in place. Okay? So I feel like it's you finding that order. It's you finding that balance. I do feel that a lot of you Virgos are going to be really sentimental and really nostalgic energy. And I even see some of you going through old boxes. So I don't know if you're going through storage and you're like, you're finding like old like photo albums and pictures or old toys or things that used to be in your room. I feel this is a big part of your release as well. And I feel some of you may be feeling overwhelmed by this and you may be asking for help. You may be having a good friend or a romantic partner, like you're just wanting them to not necessarily do physical work, but to just be there with you as you process the stuff that you're going through. Because I feel like some of you are having to go through like items, and it's bringing up a lot of sentimental energy. It's bringing up a lot of memories, a lot of emotions, and you're just wanting that person there to like hold energetic space, to hold emotional space for you as you're processing. So it's interesting energy. I'm curious, those of you that you encounter something like this, what might be going on for you. But you may want to check out your moon sign and rising sign videos. Some weeks those are going to resonate with you more than your sun sign. If you want love and romance readings, you can click on the love reading link in the description and watch those. If you would like a private reading with me, you can go to calendly.com/amethystangelite and schedule a private reading with me there. There's also a link in the description. Some of you have been very kind, been reaching out and asking about sending donations and tips for the videos. You don't have to, especially with today's interference. I know that noise is really annoying, but if you do feel moved to do so, I do appreciate it. There's a link in the description for that as well. So thank you guys for tuning in. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you all again next week. Take care, my dears.